Hi guys, welcome back to our channel Coders Lobby. In this video, we are going to learn about that how we can read an Excel file in UiPath Studio. So for example, you have a project and you want to perform some Excel related task like read an Excel file or write an Excel file. So how you can do it? How you can achieve it? In UiPath Studio, there are two activities available for this kind of task. So in this video, we are going to cover that how we can read an Excel file, and in our upcoming videos, we will perform some other Excel related tasks using other Excel activities. But in this video, we are only going to see that how we can read any Excel file in our system through UiPath. So in left side in activities panel, I'll search read range. And now you can see two activities, read range Excel activity and read range workbook activity, right? One is come under Excel and another is come under workbook. So what is the difference in between these two activities? Because both are used to read an Excel file. So for example, if Excel application is not installed in your system, then you can't use Excel read range activity, but you can use workbook read range activity, it will work. But if you try to use Excel read range activity without installed Excel application in your system, then definitely you will get an error. And but workbook read range activity is work no matter Excel application installed in your system or not. So in this video, we will use both activities to read an Excel file one by one. We will see an example of both activities, but first I'll show you the Excel file which we are going to read. So for this, I'll go into project, and in project we have a data folder, and in data folder you can see Excel file name employee data. So I'll open this file to show you the data. So in this Excel file, we can see employees data with headers, first name, last name, company address. So this data we will read using read range activity. So first I will take workbook read range activity, and in workbook path I will pass a path of an Excel file. Sheet name is sheet 1, and this is a range A1 to A2, but I want to read all Excel data available in Excel file. So what I will do is I'll keep like this in the string, a blank string I'll keep in this field to read all Excel data. So if you want to read a specific range of data in Excel file, then you have to write a range in this field. But I want to read all Excel data from an Excel file, so I'll keep like this. And if I go to properties panel, then here we can see range, sheet name, workbook, which is already given, and add headers. So it is check right now. So I'll keep it check because I also want to read headers also. And in output, I'll give one variable name like Excel DT. So all the data will store into this Excel DT variable. So now we are ready to read an Excel file. Just we need to click on debug button or run file. So I click on run file to run the process. So process has been completed, but we can't see result. So to see the result in output panel, I'll need to convert data table into a CSV format. Then only we can able to write all Excel data in output panel. So what I will do is I'll search output data table. Okay, so through this activity we can convert data table into CSV format. In property panels, in input I'll pass Excel DT variable, and in output I'll give a variable name Excel CSV data. CSV data. Okay. I'll take another activity, write line activity. Through this activity, we can write a data into our output panel and we can see the result. So now I'll pass CSV data here because converted data is stored in this variable only. Now I'll run the process. Okay, process has been completed and now we can see the result here. You can see first name, last name, company name, address, city, country, postal, phone, email, web. So this is the headers available in the Excel and these are the data. Here you can see. So all these are data you can see in our panel. So we have seen that how we can use the read range activity and how we can read an Excel file through this activity. Okay, so now a time to use another read range activity which has come under Excel, and for this I'll simply search Excel here and we'll find activity read range, but we can't use the read range activity without Excel application scope. So first I'll take Excel application scope, and under Excel application scope we can use read range activity like this. We don't need a workbook read range now, so I'll remove from the sequence, and first I'll pass the path of a file. Okay, and in read range activity, add headers is check, range is empty. That means we can read all data available in the Excel file, and only we need to write a output data table here. So data table is already created. I'll use the same variable here also, and just need to check the scope of the variable. Okay, so Excel workflow is the scope. Okay, so now we can run the process and see the result. Okay, so process has been completed and now only we need to check the output. So it is blank. You can see it is blank right now. Why it is blank? Because the variable is not passing. So I will pass a variable in write line activity. CSV. Right. Okay, so now I am going to run the process. We'll check output panel. Now you can see result. Result we can see in output panel. So successfully we are reading data through this activity, and in this video we have learned that how we can read an Excel file by using read range activity. One is come under Excel and the another is come under workbook. So you can use any of them and achieve this task. I hope the concept of read Excel is clear through this video, and if you like this video then please press the like button and also share this video on your social media platform, and also press the notification bell so that you can get the latest update about our upcoming videos, and also not forget to subscribe our channel. We need your support. I'll meet you in next video. Till then, goodbye.